Danielle Smith, Sandra's founding director, to talk us through the music and the cultural background to Aziz Ibrahim. But first of all, Danielle, what is Sandra's
group? Well, Sandra's is a small charity based in London that has been around since 2005. And its primary mission is to bring the story of the Sahrawi people to audiences through the arts, and particularly through music. And as you know, it's a subject that very few people have heard about.
Well, Aziza has got a beautiful new album out, but let's start at the beginning. Aziza was born in a refugee camp on the western side of the Sahara.
In southwest Algeria, in refugee camps based in southwest Algeria. She was born there because her mother fled the invasion in 1975 in Morocco. And she was pregnant with Aziza, so she was born soon after arriving in the refugee camps that were being set up there to receive the mass exodus of people.
You've been working with Aziza for many years now.
Yes, it's been a privilege and a real joy to know Aziza. We met in 2007 when I was organising the first Sandblast Festival of Arts and Culture for the Western Sahara in London. And we invited Aziza, we were the first people to actually bring Aziza over to the UK. And I knew the moment she arrived here that she was going to be a big name in the future.
Well, I've been watching Aziza at work this morning, we've been sound checking for the last couple of hours. It seems to me you're a very confident band leader as well as singer and writer. Is this typical of your sort of cultural background? Are you very strong women?
Should I speak for her, or should I ask her to speak for us?
Yes.
La pregunta es, te he visto que es muy, tienes mucha confianza en la manera que estás manejando tu banda. ¿Quién sabe si esta es la manera en que generalmente las mujeres son en tu sociedad?
Sí, bastante motivadas y bastante echadas para adelante. La mujer saharaui es una mujer que es muy fuerte y que ha sabido siempre manejarse en las situaciones.
So they know how to manage the situation.
According to
Aziza, well.
Women in Sahrawi society are very forthright and they know what they want and they know how to do things.
I love it. Before we hear the first song, is this rhythm that we're going to hear a very traditional rhythm? Es muy tradicional.
Primero de julio, dirías que es un ritmo muy tradicional.
Sí, generalmente los ritmos que toco al tabal son ritmos tradicionales. Luego, pues, son compaginados con los ritmos de Nico Roca y lo que aportan cada uno de los miembros de la música.
Yes, basically the rhythms that she's playing on the tabal with Khulut song are traditional rhythms that then also integrate some other rhythms that have been brought in by Nika as well.
And I know Aziza has written a little introduction to each song, so let's hear what Aziza says about this person.
So her first song, Khulut, which means resist, is a song dedicated to Aziza's mother, who represents the struggle, the courage and the resistance of Sahara.